Concept. So as we have studied in a previous class, so object-oriented programming is in one of the real modularized programming where the software can be developed based on the real world entity. So here in object-oriented programming, so it will be basically considering data in terms of an object. So I'll tell you what is an object. So in previous session also we studied, we learned what is an object, what is class. Just I'll revise those things so that it will be helpful for you. Okay. So here objects are nothing but objects are the real model entity, or it is a real world entity. So which combine both the data and the member functions which operate on that data. Okay. Object is a collection of data and the functions which are required to operate on those data. So that is called an object. Okay. It will bind the data and functions to execute in an exact way. Okay. So I will also be able to use this data for as a real world. Why we are saying that it is a real world means because the object can be, it may be a person, it may be a place, it may be a table. Okay. So any real thing, it is as a data, it can be behavior. So the object, we are saying that the object is a real world entity. When we come to the next concept, so it is the class. Class is an instance of object, or else we can also say that the objects can be used as a user-defined type with the help of a class. So hence class is a collection of data members and member functions. Whatever the data we are taking and whatever the functions to be operate on that data, so that is called as a class. So data abstraction. Okay, so data abstraction is nothing but so handling of objects without knowing its background detail or explanation. Whatever the data we are taking, we are not taking its background detail. Just we are collecting the data. Okay, so that process is called data abstraction. Okay, data encapsulation. So data encapsulation, again it is a basic concept of OOPs which defines that. So encapsulation, encapsulating means binding or combining the data and function into a single list. Suppose if it is a data and here the function to operate on those data. Okay. So for example, if you are collecting the student data, so what are the students have the properties? Student have name, register number, class, fees, course. So these are the general attributes of the students. Whenever we are collecting those as data, then we need to take what are the calculations we need to perform. Okay, to read data we require some function. To display those data we require one function, is it not? Okay. So binding of data and function into a single unit is called an encapsulation. Okay, the process of binding the data and the function into a capsule or into a unit is nothing but data encapsulation. Okay, that is also one of the basic concept of OOPs. So another concept is inheritance. Inheritance is a process of creating a new class with an already existing class. Okay, so already one parent class is there. From that class we are inheriting some or all the properties of that parent class along with the new its own properties. So that is called an inheritance. Okay, so overloading means using the same operator or the function we are utilizing for different tasks. So that is called overloading. So here we have a operator overloading and function overloading. So in operator overloading, same operator can be used to perform different tasks. In the previous session, I took the example of plus operator. Okay, so plus operator can be used to add two integer numbers. Plus operator can be used to add two floating point numbers. And plus operator can also be used to combine two names or two strings. So that we have studied in a previous class. So that is called an operator overloading. And in case of function overloading, so same name functions can be used to perform a different task. Same thing is here, polymorphism. Polymorphism is also one of the important concept of OOPs, where poly means many, morph means taking more than one form. Okay, poly means many, means with the same name, so it is taking different forms of the function, that is called a polymorphism. Okay, so dynamic binding means, so here the process of binding the data is called a dynamic binding. So another important concept of OOP is message passing. So as you know that in the OOPs programming or it's in object oriented, OOPs means object oriented programming. In object oriented programming, so we are not only taking one object, we are taking a collection of object where if the those objects they want to share the data or information, they require some messaging. Okay, so that is called the one object will be share the message to another object in order to share the data and the function. The message passing is a process of communicating or sending the message from one object to another object in order to share the data or information. These are the basic concepts of OOPs. We have an examination. We are going to ask explain the basic concept of OOPs for 5 marks. Or particularly, he'll ask what is inheritance, what is overloading, or what do you mean by data encapsulation, what do you mean by data abstraction for 3 marks, or for 1 mark, what is class, what is object. So this type of questions will going to be asked. Okay. So next we'll come across the advantages of OOPs. OOPs is nothing but an object-oriented program. So what are the advantages will be there? So as we already discussed that, so object-oriented programming is one of the modularized programming. Modularized programming in the sense, so the whole program we are dividing into several modules. Okay, several modules means several units. Okay, for example, if my program is 100 lines. Okay, so it is somewhat difficult to remember those 100 lines, isn't it? So what we are doing, so I am breaking that 100 lines into 10 lines. 10 lines one unit, another 10 lines another unit, another 10 lines another unit. So other than easily we can study the 10 lines programmer, we can easily study, is it not? So by combining them, we are finding the solution for that 10 lines and we are getting the whatever the answer we are getting, we are keeping it aside. Okay, so like that for all the 10 lines we are going to be find that answer. So finally we are going to merge the whole answers. So it is somewhat easier. It is something like dividing the project in a group. Okay, so for example, suppose if 5 members group is there, we are going to be give the project. So what you people will do, you will going to divide the that project in a group. How one will take the collection of information, one will write the writing work, one will take so the hard copy work, one will take the soft copy work. Okay, so like that. So after doing that particular work, so for finally they are going to merge all the things. So then we'll get the project completed, is it not? So like that. So here modularity means breaking up of whole program into several units or several module. Okay, so here object oriented programming is the modularized programming. Modularized programming in a sense, so the whole program we are taking in a unit wise, so that it will be easily we can find the answer, and even it will be help us to find the solution or remember easier. Okay, so the modularization of OOPs using object and classes will be easy. So that is one of the advantage of OOPs. So here as we are using the inheritance, the sharing of common code, inheritance with the same code. What is the inheritance meaning? So acquiring or taking the properties of the already created class from the new class. Okay, so same thing we are taking, same data we are taking, same function we are taking, along with that adding the new data or function. Okay, so with this what happens? So whatever the function we are writing once, the same function can be utilized again and again just by taking its name. No need to write that again once again. So that the sharing of common code will also be easier in case of object oriented programming. Okay, so encapsulation helps security. So how the encapsulation is helping? Encapsulation means what I said, so binding of data or combining the data and function into a unit, so that the if one object data will be bind here, for example see here, so this is the one object one, so this data and function will be here, and object two, this data and the function will be here. Okay, binding the data and until and unless they are not giving the permission, they cannot access the code of this object but the second object. Okay, so that is called the encapsulation. Hence, we can maintain the security. Here, no one can hack our data. Okay, no one can misuse our data. Okay, so because it is safe, until and unless we are not giving the permission, the data will be not transferred outside the unit. Okay, so that is the encapsulation. Okay, so it will also helps the security. That is also one of the advantage of OOPS. So that inheritance helps sharing the common code. As I said that the same data or function can be shared with the different objects. So that can be easily possible with the help of inheritance, and this is easily maintainable. So writing of these code will be very easier, because here we are taking the real world concepts. As I said that object may be a place, object may be a name of the employee, object may be one of the record, object may be a real, any table, real things. Okay, so writing the data on those real things can be made easier. Okay, it will be very easy. So implementation of these programs, object oriented programs, will be easier compared to our that is procedure oriented programming. Okay, reduces software development time, because these programs are very easy. Here we are taking the real time activities, okay, real time objects, real time data we are using. So hence the software development time is also be easier. And one more thing, what we are doing, we are using the modularized programming. Modularized in the sense, so same code will be repeating, means we are writing that code only once, just we are by using the name, we are accessing that one. And here the whole program is divided into several modules. So hence the software development will be very easier. Development of software, creation of software will be very easier. So these are the certain advantages of OOPS. Okay. So even this question will be asked for either 2 marks or for 3 marks. What are the advantages of OOPS? So next we have limitations. Okay. So in limitations, so it allows only the standard set of objects and the classes. Okay. Only it takes the standardized set. Okay. Only the whatever the only standard keywords will be there, standard modularities will be there. Only that it will take. So it is somewhat difficult to remember all those standard things. So then it is by using the objects and classes, hence we are developing a program. So that process is somewhat complex. Suppose if we are taking more number of objects, more number of classes will be creating. So then it will be very difficult for creating that program. It is somewhat difficult. Hence the complete process is somewhat complex. Okay. So then real world program, it is somewhat difficult to convert the real world program to object oriented. Okay, so here we are taking the object as a real world entity, but it is still, it is difficult to one who is expert only he can do that. Okay, so one who is not expert in object oriented programming, again he will face difficulty to convert the real world program to the object oriented programming. Okay, so that classes with different names can again it will be create somewhat difficulties. Hence it this is also one of the limitation. And so overly generalized, whatever the classes we are using, it is overly generalized, because we are inheriting the classes from the parent class. We are creating the child class, again from the child class we are creating one more child class. So that maintenance should be somewhat difficult. So these are the some of the limitations of object oriented programming. So next we have applications. Applications in the sense users. What are the users of where we are using the object oriented programming? So here the object oriented programming can be used in computer graphics. I think people have seen computer graphics. Computer graphics means whatever the sceneries you will see in your computers. Okay, moving motion pictures. Okay, so that are all the computer graphics. Whatever the motion pictures will be there, and then nowadays you are able to see 3D wallpapers. Okay, and moving wallpapers, live wallpapers, like wallpapers people have seen, you know, like water dropping, raindrops, moving of leaves and all. Okay, so that is called computer graphics. That is sceneries, images, moving pictures, motion pictures, okay? So that all will comes under the computer graphics. In order to generate those things, we are using the object oriented programming. Like some games also, we have 3D games, 2D games also, no? In that, many graphics we have used. Many graphics means sceneries, like in the car racing, so many buildings will be there. If it is a mountain racing, different different types of mountains will be there, and the sceneries, it will be however the car is moving, so it is taking the different different places. So that also called computer graphics. In order to generate those also, we are using an object oriented programming. So this object oriented programming is also used in the CAD and CAM. CAD means computer aided design. CAM means computer aided manufacturing. So computer aided design, mainly it will be helped for designing that is 3D models. Okay, it may be the building model, it may be your machinery models. So in order to develop the 3D model, okay, so we are using this computer aided design. Computer aided manufacturing, it is also a programmer which will help us whatever the design we have created with the help of CAD. So the same thing will be implemented as a one of the simple structure. Okay, so in order to help for that software, in order to build that software also, we are using an object oriented programming. Okay, so then object oriented will also be used in creating the object oriented databases. Okay, in order to create the object oriented database, database means the collection of a huge amount of data. Okay, collection of huge amount of data, different type forms of data is nothing but database. In order to collect those data also, we are using the an object oriented programming. So that is also one of the application. So it also using real time systems. Real time systems in the sense where we are going to fix some time in a system. For example, your microwave system. In your microwave system, what you will do? You will fix some time, is it not? In order to bake or in order to cook something, some timing will be there. So as per that time, what the microwave will do? It will behave as per your instructions, is it right? So, and one of the real time system will be your washing machine. Okay, so that is the automatic washing machine is also one of the example for real time system. Automatic washing machine, how it will behave? So you will going to be fix the times. Okay, for washing how many minutes, for rinsing how many minutes again, then for drying how much time it is required. So that all the things you will fixed before itself, so that after finishing all the tasks, then it will give the beep sound and it will be stopped. So in order to implement those things also, we are using the object oriented programming. Real time system means where we are fixing some times and we are executing the task. So that systems are nothing but a real time system. Real time means at present it is working on. Okay, at present it will going to be work on. So that is called a real time system. So in this also we are going to be use our object oriented programming. So then simulation and modeling, as I said that simulation and modeling will be is nothing but designing the big machineries, big in order to drawing the big building designs and all. So that is called simulation and modeling. So in that also we are going to be implementing, we are going to use our object oriented programming. Okay, so next we have we are also using in artificial intelligence and expert system. I think you people have known about this artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence means the one who is using the very small devices, that is the micro systems. Okay, like button type cameras will be there, maybe a button type camera. Okay, so in series and all, you people have seen many equipments, that is a computer equipments which is very small in size. Okay, so in those things and all, we are using our object oriented programming. And one more thing, so that is the sensors, whatever the doors will be there, automatic sensors. Okay, as soon as we go in many malls, we'll see, you know, as soon as we go near the door, so it will get open. So that is the automatic sensors will be there. So in order to operate those also, we are using an object oriented programming. And in expert systems, that is in order to develop the heavy systems and all, so the expertized systems and all, we are using this object oriented programming. So this completes your fifth chapter, that is the basic concepts of OOPS. So hope you people have understand this clearly. If you have any doubts, you can give